Hello, learner. Welcome to Agriculture Lesson for Grade 5. Today, we are going to learn about the indigenous food crops. Indigenous food crops are the crops that grow naturally in the garden. Some of these indigenous food crops have been adopted by the human beings, and they are now grown artificially to provide food for Kenyans or people. Examples of the indigenous crops have spider wheat, arrowroot, cassava, sorghum, sweet potatoes, black nightshade, cowpeas, pumpkin, African kales, jutamalos. These are also examples, same examples of the indigenous food as I mentioned earlier. Still, we have around four groups. We have the vegetables, crops, cereals, legumes, and tubers or roots. These are some of the examples that I have mentioned. You can see them. Indigenous vegetables, crops. Indigenous vegetables are pigweed, black nightshade, spiderweed, pumpkin. We eat the leaves of these vegetables. They provide us with a vitamin which help in protecting our body against the diseases. Still, the examples have shown the pictures of different crops, say black nightshade, managu, saga, and so on. So still, the examples of the vegetables that we eat, especially the indigenous food crops. We still have the pumpkin, malenge, and so on. We have the jutamalos, African kales. So, indigenous cereals crops are those whose grains are eaten. The indigenous cereals such as millet, finger millet, and sorghum, they are rich in carbohydrate, which give us the energy to work. They can grow well in area with a little rainfall. These are examples of the grain, the cereals I've mentioned. I've said finger millet, sorghum, and so on. Indigenous root crops. Root crops are those whose roots are eaten. The roots such as cassava, sweet potatoes, arrowroot, and yams, we eat the roots of these crops. They are rich in carbohydrates. Examples of the roots, we have arrowroot, have yams, we have potatoes and cassava. The indigenous food are food that our great parents used to eat. These plants are grown and usually are used by the community in those areas as a food. When surplus are sold, they also generate income. This food benefits us in a number of ways, like providing us with carbohydrates, minerals, vitamins that protect us from the disease. They also help in healing of wounds. Some of these plants need to be handled with care, like sting nettle can cause an itching sensation on the skin and should be handled with care. Ensure you put on gloves when you handle such leaves. Therefore, they are important in reducing food shortage and hunger in the country. Most of these crops can be grown using organic manure, hence no need buying expensive artificial fertilizer. Let's look at the importance of indigenous crops. Why are they important? Lana, why are they important? One, they are rich in nutrients that keep our body healthy. Vegetables are rich in vitamins that protect the body against the diseases. roots and cereal crops are rich in carbohydrate, which provide the body with energy. The cereals form part of the staple food in our community. They are able to grow under the various climatic conditions. They provide us with the nutrients that give us the energy, protect our body from the disease and build our body. Indigenous food crops are much important to our nutrition because they provide required nutrients and minerals to our body, and they provide food security. Indigenous food are used for consumption to give the nutrients. Some indigenous crops are used as a medicine. They provide carbohydrate from root tubers and cereals, vitamin from leafy crops, and minerals such as zinc, iron from plants like black nightshade and spiderweed. They are rarely affected by pests. They grow naturally along the fences and under the sheds and well in the local environments. They are sold to earn money for the other uses. You can sell them and you get money. They provide us with the nutrients that give us energy. They protect our body from diseases. They build our body. When we eat indigenous food, we become strong. Lana, we have come to the end of our lesson. Thank you for listening. Thank you.